Topography of Ancient Greece. Ancient Greece was not a country, but a civilization. It began as a collection of small, self-governed city-states along the Mediterranean coast. Later, it expanded to include most of the islands in the Aegean Sea. There were also Greek colonies as far west as France and Spain, and as far east as parts of modern-day Turkey and Ukraine. These colonies were important trading posts. Mainland Greece is surrounded by the Aegean Sea to the east, the Cretan and Libyan Seas to the south, and the Ionian Sea to the west. The Aegean and Ionian Seas are scattered with thousands of islands and islets. There are four main peninsulas, land masses that jut out into the sea. Each peninsula, and many of the Greek islands too, has peninsulas of its own. This makes the coastline very jagged, which is why there's so much of it. Mainland Greece is extremely mountainous. The highest mountain, 2,917 meters, is Mount Olympus, which was said to be the home of the gods. The longest mountain range is called the Pindus. It runs down the middle of the main peninsula from north to south. The longest river, the Archelaus, originates high in the Pindus Mountains. In the summer, many rivers almost completely dry up. Then, when the mountain snow melts in spring, they become raging torrents. Around 80% of the land is mountainous. For the ancient Greeks, these mountains were perfect for herding animals and defending cities from invading armies. But the soil lacked the minerals and other nutrients needed to grow crops. Instead, most grain had to be imported. There was, however, one crop that grew particularly well in this region – olives. They grew so well that olive oil was used not only as food and fuel, but people even bathed in it and used it as currency. Goods such as olive oil and pottery were taken by boat to nearby islands and far-flung lands, where they were traded for grain and other, more exotic items